Hi friends, and welcome back to my channel. I asked you guys a couple of weeks ago on Facebook and Instagram, I believe, to list some topics and that you would want to see me discuss. So one that kept coming up was conflict resolution at work between employees and managers and employee relations and all that good stuff. So today I'm going to concentrate on conflict resolution at the workplace. So if this is a topic that interests you or you might could use yourself, please keep watching. Okay, so let's get started. This topic can be, how can I say it? It applies to managers, you know, manager to manager, employee to manager, employee to employee. This is what I do at work. I am one of the employee and labor relations generalists at my job. So I deal with this not a whole lot, but enough. So the first thing is you have to, whether it's, and this, what I'm saying applies to all relationships, work relationships. So it, like I said, it could be manager to manager, manager to employee, etc. Of course, if it's your manager and you're the subordinate, you know, your steps may be a little bit different, but these tools here apply for all. So first, you need to talk and communicate. A lot of times that's the biggest issue. There's no communication or there's miscommunication. So first, instead of letting it stew and fester, address the issue head on by talking about it. And I'm not saying talk about it in front of everybody. Find a safe, quiet place where, and private place, that's the main thing. So other people can't hear it and the gossip rumor mill starts at work, but somewhere you two can go talk and not make a scene, be respectful and talk to each other. So communication is the first key. A lot of times this is a miscommunication, and by talking about it, you figure out that someone, there was a disconnect somewhere. And at my old job, I have several old jobs, but one of my jobs, my first job in HR, was at a staffing company called Aerotech. And we had a thing in our office called carefrontation. And so that was a spin on the word confrontation, but it's carefrontation because you care about your employee or your coworker, and you want to resolve this issue so you can have a healthy, successful work environment. So carefrontation is what I call it, where you go in, you talk, and try to resolve it. Consider the reason for the issue. You know, is this person going through something? Is this person on edge or stressed out? Is this like a time at work where it's a high demand, you know, like, is this your end of year stuff going on, whatever. Consider what this person may be going on. They just, you know, something in their personal life, just lost a loved one, or they're pregnant or whatever. It could be a lot of things going on. So don't make any assumptions about it. You know, again, that circles back to talking about it, but, you know, kind of consider, well, yeah, she did just lose a grandma, or, you know, whatever. Like, that could make people deflect their feelings in other places. So a lot of times when, I haven't had a lot of conflict at work, but when someone's been snippy with me or whatever, I later find out like it was something that had nothing to do with me at all. Again, the most important thing is to respect each other. Respect each other, respect each other's opinions. Listen, you gotta listen. And just respect all the way around. Respect their feelings, respect their opinions, and respect the workplace. Don't be in the workplace acting the fool, because that's when HR gets involved and you get escorted out the building, okay? So, you know, just respect. But if all that doesn't work, what we're doing in my job now, and I'm sure a lot of jobs do this, HR, instead of first thing we do is jump into discipline or writing people up, we see if it's something that can be mediated. So you might need to seek mediation, or even if you don't have someone to be an official mediator, a coworker that's non-biased or whatever, someone you feel comfortable with that can just sit in and kind of like hear both sides and not be biased. So that seems to have worked. I've done that with two managers. I've done that with a manager and a subordinate. And I've done that with coworkers. You know, somebody said something or they thought they said something and heard this in the break room, blah, 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 blah. But it's really just talking about it. Now, let's talk about something else. There's a difference in a misunderstanding, miscommunication, something that can be talked about. If it escalates to something like harassment, you're being harassed or feel you're being harassed or bullied. Yeah, bullying occurs with adults, believe it or not. Workplace bullying is real. Or you feel threatened. We've had, unfortunately, I can say in my career, I've had a couple of employees that like to throw hands. Why? We are grown. But anyway, it happens. So of course, if that happens, that's sometimes it's not something you can talk out. A lot of times it's not. So that's when HR gets involved. And unfortunately, sometimes and most times, if it's harassing and it can be proven, I can't talk, it's Monday morning, I didn't get all my coffee. If it's harassment and or bullying or gets physical, unfortunately, HR will get involved, and 9 times out of 10, it will result in some form of discipline or termination. So the quick and dirty for workplace conflict resolution is 1, communication, respect, listen, mediation, consideration, all those come into play and work hand in hand. The ultimate goal is you want to be comfortable in your workplace and you want the other person to feel comfortable, because at the end of the day, you guys work at the same place. You spend most of your time together and you should be working towards a common goal for overall success of the organization. So that's the quick and dirty with workplace conflict resolution. Now, if there's specific, you know, issues around it, you know, that may be more complex, then of course that may take a different turn. If you're a union environment, sometimes a union gets involved and HR and the union and the employees work together to find a workable solution. Many times, if they're in the same department, it may be where you need to transfer to a different department if you can't work things out. And unfortunately, sometimes it has been so bad, some people just end up leaving the organization. But that's not what we want, what HR wants, or what management or leadership should want. We want to work it out and, you know, find a win-win for everybody. But let's keep it 100. Sometimes people are just bad apples and they spoil the bunch. So sometimes it's not a bad thing if they decide to leave or if they're asked to leave. That happens too. Some conflict just can't be resolved because that person is toxic to the organization for whatever reason, whatever, you know. So also, I did not mention this. If someone is going through something and they tend to display it at work, just like kids, when they're going through stuff, they act out. Adults act out. So that's why we always look at the whole situation and investigate. When I say we, I mean HR. We investigate and determine if the employee assistance program or EAP would be helpful. You know, sometimes if people just get the help they need, then they're a whole different person. So it could be, you know, substance abuse, stress, depression, post-traumatic stress or secondary stress or secondary trauma. You know, I deal with social workers, so we have a lot of secondary trauma a lot of times. Or just personal stuff in life. You know, like I've shared with you guys, I've been very vocal. Now, luckily, I did not bring that to the workplace. Well, actually, I did when I was teaching. I went through a temporary depression and when my father died, grieving. And I wasn't issue at work. Like I wasn't going off on people or anything like that, but I just wasn't present. Like I checked out. I was just there. And, you know, I didn't realize it till after the fact. I was depressed. So, you know, that I wasn't there for my students. Like, they didn't go without, they weren't neglected. I wasn't just sitting there, none of that. But I wasn't that revved up, fired up teacher every day. I wasn't the best that I could have been for my students. But, you know, you live and you learn. But anyway, I get off on a tangent. But I'm just saying, sometimes stuff in life will bring you to a place where you're not who you normally are at work. So if we can see that, address that, and get you the help you need, you know, once that's dealt with, you're still that great employee that we hired. So anyway, guys, I didn't want to ramble. I hope this made sense. But if you're that employee, and I think a lot of you guys that asked for this wanted this because of this reason that I'm about to say, if you are having issues at work or conflict with your employee or your manager, if you don't feel comfortable going to them and talking to them one-on-one, that's what HR is there for. And believe it or not, guys, there are laws in place and policies in place where you can't be or should not be reprimanded or have them treat you differently because you went to get help about the situation. Retaliation. They can't do that. That's the word I was looking for in my brain. Like, what's that word? They can't retaliate against you for expressing your concern to HR. Like, hey, you know, I'm going through this. Can you guys help me find a workaround? And like I said, sometimes it's easy as just talking it out, transferring to another location. Hold on one second. Gotta take this. I have been waiting on that call. But yeah, like I said, it might be as simple as a transfer or, you know, just a departmental shift or just, like I said, talking it out or whatever. There is hope. Don't sit at work and be upset and depressed and think you're stuck here forever. There's no help, because there is. There is. And you know what, guys? There was an issue with one employee that she was so upset. Like, she just felt like her boss was just out to get her. And, like, she worked on, you know, did her part, tried to talk it out, resolve it out. It kind of got better for her, you know, where she could manage it. But she was thinking about leaving and, you know, going somewhere else. And I talked to her. I said, don't leave. Just, you know, just relax. Don't let anyone, you're doing great here. Don't let anyone run you away. And, you know, she was like, well, I'll try. I'll try. You know, I got her some help to talk to somebody, whatever. So she stuck it out. And guess what happened? That manager ended up leaving the organization on their own. They got another job. They left. And I was like, see, you were about to leave this great job that you love with these coworkers that you love because of one person. And see how God worked that out? You went on. I didn't tell her this, but I'm like, see how God worked that out? That person went on about their business. So anyway, there is help out there. Just talk to somebody, whether it's talk to that person directly, get a mediator, talk to HR, whatever works for you. Just talk to somebody, guys. Conflict is just that. It is conflict, but it doesn't have to last forever. So I hope this was helpful. I didn't mean to babble if I did. If you have questions or specific issues or situations that you want some guidance on, feel free to drop it in the comments and I'll be glad to help you. If you want to see any other similar topics or have any other suggestions, drop those down there as well. And I will see you guys in the next vlog. Have a great week. Bye, guys.